Alrighty, so it's no secret that vinyl plank flooring is just taking over the marketplace and everybody wants this installed in their house. You've caught the bug and you want to know a little bit more about this product. So in this video, I'm going to break down the top 10 questions about vinyl plank flooring so you can make an educated decision on if it's the right fit for you. And if this is the first time you stop by to see my nonsense, I'm Carpet Mike from Carpet Expert Blueprint, and if you want to learn how to make $75 to $125 per hour doing really basic repairs in the carpet and flooring industry, then stop by the carpetrepaircheatcode.com after this video. But let's dive right into these questions here. First things first, is vinyl plank flooring good for bathrooms? Yes, it is. It's vinyl. It's waterproof. You're not going to have any issues with moisture like all the crazy people used to do with laminates in their bathrooms back in the day, and it was just mold everywhere. With vinyl plank flooring, you're not going to have those issues, so go ahead and hook it up in those bathrooms. Just make sure you seal the edges so you don't get standing water sitting under the floor. Other than that, the product is going to be just fine. Next question. What is vinyl plank flooring made of? I cannot believe this question comes up more often than not. It's vinyl plank flooring. Made of vinyl. Next question. Is vinyl plank flooring durable? Yes, absolutely it is durable, but keep in mind, if you buy a cheap product, you will get cheap product results. There are cheap vinyl plank flooring out there, and they're typically $1.50 a square foot or cheaper. If you find products like that, just know it's typically hot garbage and it's gonna scratch and scuff and not last. But if you're doing a quick flip rental property, you just need a slop and pop, it'll suffice. I always tell people anything $250 a square foot and up is typically, in most cases, going to be a good product for you. So keep that in mind when you're shopping for your plank flooring. Next question. Is vinyl plank flooring waterproof? Yep, covered that earlier. Vinyl plank flooring is waterproof. It's made of vinyl, so you won't have any issues of swelling or mold growing in it or anything like that. Fantastic replacement to the laminates. Next question. What brand of vinyl plank flooring is best? Okay. So here's the thing about the flooring industry. Everybody private labels everything. So it's tough to say that this particular brand is the best of all vinyl plank floorings because everybody produces it, they slap their own label on it, and they're good to go. So if you are shopping for vinyl plank flooring, just consider anything above $250 a square foot to $5 a square foot would be your banger. You're gonna get decent to fantastic products in that price point. So kind of shop it like that versus names. Next question, will vinyl plank flooring scratch? Yes and no. This is the other big myth out there. It's scratch resistant, not scratch proof. And a lot of people just buy it thinking it's going to be fantastic. It's still a vinyl. If something sharp is on the bottom of your couch or your table and you drag it along it, it is going to scratch the stuff out of it. But if you just do your day-to-day living, it will scuff and you could clean it up, but it is not scratch proof. It is scratch resistant. Remember, a vinyl still is soft, so be careful with it, but it can take a beating. I will say that. Next question. Can vinyl plank flooring be installed on stairs? Yes, it can. We have several videos in the playlist showing how to do that. Everybody has a different strategy, but yes, it can be installed on stairs and it will take a beating. It's okay. It'll hold up to all that traffic. So it is a great thing to consider for long-term traffic there. Next question. How to cut vinyl plank flooring? There's a number of different ways how to cut your vinyl plank flooring. We use a knife, just score it a few times, and then we snap it off and we're good to go. You could also use a jigsaw. You could use a miter saw. There's a number of different ways to go about it. But really, if you got a good utility blade and you're a little savvy with your cutting skills, that really is all you need to cut the flooring and get it installed. Next question, how much vinyl plank flooring do I need? Okay, this is a fun one here because a lot of people don't follow these rules. Measure out your room. Let's say you have 1,000 square feet collectively throughout the house. Add 10% to it just in case. So if you have an exact 1,000 square feet, order 1,100 square feet to know that you will have enough for all the cuts and twists and turns and bad cuts, all that fun stuff. You'll be good to go. You could always return extra boxes if they're unopened. Don't be that dude that opens up your boxes and then tries to repackage it, jacked up corners, and stick it back on the shelves. Nothing more aggravating than that. Next question, and it's actually the final question. Where to install vinyl plank flooring? I say install it everywhere. Everywhere, except for your bedrooms, if you live in the Midwest like us. Houses get cold in the Midwest. You want that good soft carpet that when you hop out of bed, drop on the carpet, you're good to go. that's the way to roll. But if you're in the South where it's warm year round, put that stuff everywhere. It is a hot commodity right now. Everybody loves vinyl plank flooring. So consider it everywhere you want it, because it's holding up to all the hype at the moment. So that's all I have for you on all the questions in the world of vinyl plank flooring. Like I said in the beginning of this video, if you're interested in creating a side hustle doing repairs in the carpet and flooring industry, drop by carpetrepaircheatcode.com, link below this video. Comment below with any questions as well. Thank you so much for tuning in, and I'll see you in the next video.